About 11:30 p.m. on Sunday night, a 58-year-old male bus driver drove a passenger bus in a southerly direction on Wine Country Drive. As he entered the roundabout to turn west onto the Hunter Expressway, he lost control of that vehicle and it fell over onto its left side onto a guardrail. As a result of that motor vehicle accident, 10 people are deceased, 9 at the scene, and 1 later died in hospital. We had a total of 25 people taken to hospital with a range of injuries. 12 of those people have since been released and we still have 14 in hospital, 9 at John Hunter, 2 in ICU, 1 at the Martyr, 2 at Maitland and 2 at RPA. Both those ones at RPA have had surgeries. The injuries range from lacerations to breaks and fractures. So there's a whole range of injuries, from minor injuries to very serious injuries, with 2 in ICU. We've obviously now charged that 58-year-old male bus driver. We've charged him with 11 charges, 10 of dangerous driving relating to each of those victims, and 1 of negligent driving in relation to all 10 victims. I see there's been speculation about the identity of those 10 persons. We cannot confirm the identity of those 10 victims. We will work through that disaster victim identification process over the next few days. Our investigators, our family liaison officers are speaking to the families and the victims. We are in contact. That process will continue throughout the investigation and throughout the court process. We have had debriefs with our police last night, as no doubt the other emergency services have. Some of our police are visibly distraught. It was a very chaotic scene. Obviously, we have good processes, and as the emergency services come together, we've worked well, and it's been a very thorough investigation. We'll continue to do that. But at the time of that initial response, it was quite chaotic for those attending police and other emergency services, so we'll continue to work with those personnel as we will with the community. I'm aware that Cessnock Council have set up a community crisis centre, one at Brankston, one at Singleton, and that is to provide support to the wider community. Obviously, it's a traumatic event for all the family, all the friends, from what was a wedding where people come from wide and far. I can say that in relation to the passengers, we've got people in the range from 20s to 60s, males to females, local and interstate, as you would expect when people travel far and wide for a wedding. We will continue to work with the community, we'll continue to work with the victims and witnesses moving forward, as we will with our own personnel.
You're pretty quick to lay charges. What will you be alleging in court?
Look, the 58-year-old male was the driver of the bus. He entered that roundabout driving in a manner that was inconsistent with the conditions. Obviously, the speed was too quick for him to negotiate that roundabout, causing the vehicle to fall onto its left side and cause those injuries. So the manner of dangers will relate to the manner in which he drove into that roundabout.
And you'll be relying on the cut on the passengers. Will that assist you on what their version of events?
Yeah, look, we've done a crime scene investigation. We will do further investigations in relation to the vehicle today. We've still held the scene. The vehicle has been removed. It was removed late last night. We still held the scene. We'll do some further examination today. But certainly we've spoken to a number of those witnesses already, some of the passengers on the bus, and we'll work through the rest as they're able to be spoken to.
And that's helped you build the case?
That's part of the investigation. Yeah, that was certainly a factor. Yep. Look, I won't speculate on ages. What I will say is that they're all adults and the range is right from 20 right through to 60.
And that one is still in a critical condition,
that patient, how are they going? There's 2 in ICU, both critical but stable. That's right. The latest. And can I say that in relation to those in hospital, we've had 12 released, 14 remain in hospital. That's going to change. So that was as of last night. It may have changed as of this morning. So that will continually change as we move forward.
There are allegations that the driver was bragging about the speed at which he could have
drive the bus. Is there anything you'll be alleging in court to that effect?
I won't comment on that.
Have you managed to rule out other things like mechanical issues with the bus braking and certain areas like that? Is the driver sort of given a version of events different to what witnesses have said about speed?
Look, we will conduct a mechanical examination of that vehicle today. So that will be part of the investigation process.
Did fault play a part at all?
Oh, look, I won't comment on that.
Yeah.
I beg your pardon?
Will you expect the police to...
Look, we'll work through that process with prosecutors today. Obviously, they're very serious charges. We've got 10 counts of dangerous driving occasioning death, so we'll work through that process this morning.
Did the road play a part at all, or are you looking into that as well?
Again, the whole conditions will be examined as part of the investigation, so it'll be about how the driver drove in relation to the conditions.
The bus company...
Look, I think he was obviously cleared of injury. He was arrested and taken to hospital for blood and urine tests. He was cleared of any serious injury and brought back to the station here where he was charged and held in custody. He'll appear at court today. But obviously he's been charged with some very serious charges, so that will obviously be impacting on his mental health.
So have your young, have your police had any dealings with the young couple who got married on Sunday?
I don't believe so yet, no. Our focus has been on the victims and the passengers within the bus at this stage.
The bus company that the driver was working for, have you been liaising closely with them? Have they been cooperating?
They will be working through that today, yes.
Passengers were told to get back into their seats apparently moments before the crash. Do you understand that some were still standing up when it happened, or everyone had to sit back?
Look, again, I'm not going to comment on that. That'll be part of the investigation. And as I said, we've interviewed some of those people already, and we've still got other witnesses to interview. Again, that'll be part of the investigation. Yeah. Look, that again will be part of the investigation. We will examine that as part of the investigation, yes. I was informed as of last night there was two in ICU at John Hunter.
Is the driver at all able to
talk? I'm not going to comment on that.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right, well, we have just received an update there from Cessnock Police Station with some of those details. We know obviously the driver's been charged with 11 driving offences, including 10 of dangerous driving for each of the people who have passed away. The police also providing an update on the conditions of those in hospital. 14 remain in hospital. Thankfully, 12 have been released. Of those in hospital, their injuries range from lacerations to breaks, and there are sadly a couple in ICU as well.
They are recovering at John Hunter at the moment. Mm. We're told those involved from their 20s to their 60s, there are some local, some interstate.
Yeah.
Very much the map of a wedding.
Yeah, it really is. Exactly. Supposed to be a joyous event, ended in absolute tragedy.